We never, ever, ever get taught black identity or black history. We should know why we're here, and we should also know what that meant for Britain.
This park here is, well, grown up. My size is one of the greatest places when they say school of the hard knocks, innit? It's everything for me. Yeah, I love my side. We've got the West Indian Centre over here. All right, Lee.
Oi!
All right, hello, Mrs. Brandy. I want to get rid of this, because I could reconstruct it. Right. The MC would come out and say, we've got the Jazz Hoofies, Manchester's very own Foot Patrol. Doom, 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 Jazz Hoofy. We come out there skipping like this, da da da. Da 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 da. You know what? I can't do all the moves. Into the figure four, knee drop spins. So we went down the storm, and we thought, yeah, you know what? Appreciation, thank you very much. Zipper Tafari from Manchester, my side. Entertainer, proud Mancunian. We got two great football teams. Some great groups came out of this place. Stone Roses, Carpets, New Order. And coming back to the other side, we have the great sound systems with the reggae. They shape the life or the scenery of Manchester, my side itself. First time I got introduced to house music was totally different. The 4/4 beat and the bass, it just makes us dance within a frenzy. The adrenaline jumps out your skin. How Manchester shaped the whole of the house scene was an artist called, a guy called Gerald. He's from Manchester, born and bred. Voodoo Ray, when that came out, people was going crazy over the sound what Gerald made.
When I did Voodoo Ray, there was no rules. There was no instructions. Like, I think too many rules kind of shuts people down. That tune was made for people like Zipper and them guys, you know what I mean? That tune was made for man who was dropping foot in a club. You know what I mean? They were in the club to dance. Jungle, it was like a rebel music. It couldn't have happened anywhere else. My life in Manchester, I think it was a perfect melting pot there. My parents' generation created reggae, but this jungle thing was totally British. You could hear the Gary Numan in it. You could hear the hip-hop and the electro-funk and the soul, even some 70s punk. And it was like, wow, this is our soundtrack. We're actually taking bits of music and recreating and reshaping everything, all gelled into one thing. To me, that's what jungle was. And it was like, wow, where can we go from here? Like, anywhere.
'Cause I've got stories that will make you lose your mind. I was born in Bradford, really close to Leeds, and then I ended up moving to a place called St. Anne's. It's actually quite a white area. I probably actually thought I was a white girl trying to, like, look like my friends using their fake tan. But I knew I was different, but I didn't really understand how. I'm left with me and the noise within. I fall in this dust. It wasn't until I went to uni that actually I started understanding the power of music and how it can actually get you so interested in your heritage. I just became a massive drum and bass head, and I just, like, these heavy beats with people MCing over was just, like, pure fire to me. It basically, like, introduced me to, like, dancehall, reggae, like, the whole actual dub roots. Like, something in my mind, like, exploded. And I was just like, oh, my God, getting transported to this island that I've never been to before in my life. But I felt like I'd actually come to a space which I understood, and it affected everything. My Black identity is powerful, I'm rich, but then at the same time, I'm British. So the two collide, making something spectacular. 'Cause I've got stories that will make you lose your mind. I'll spend the time just to do it all again. My journey of, like, finding my self-identity is 100% having an impact on my music. Ultimately, I want everyone to feel empowered. Take no bullshit. Like, we're the powerful women, so let's write about it. I'm coming home. Did I not tell you?
My mum came from Jamaica. There used to be a West Indian club. We used to have sound systems there. And then they'd have the dances as well. So you'd see somebody's mum, people who were in their 40s, winding up themselves. And my mind was blown. People just got their records playing, they got the mic. It was very DIY. It was exciting. So when I look at that, I think about punk and doing something outside of what is perceived as normal. I came into punk at 15 thinking there were divisions between myself and the culture. I did have a lot of conflict about it because it's like, why do I have to go and do things that aren't normally associated with Black people? What does that say about me? And then the reception that you get going to do those things from white people, yeah. Like, why are you here?
Yeah.
So it was really...
constant limbo.
Cross-pollination of things going on.
We were in a punk band called Skinny Girl Diet, and we struggled, and we saw a clear difference of how other bands have been received based on race.
Even when you're trying to make people understand, you're still going to get the very ignorant people that like how the old way was. So if you are of a certain skin complexion, oh yeah, you should be doing R&B. It does create something that can't be taken away because you've harnessed such skills with that fight. Mm. That you have you've got this hunger that a lot of other people look around and they're like, how did they get that? I want that.
I'm not doing anything different from my ancestors. You come over from Kingston, everybody hates your ass. They're like, no Blacks, no dogs, no Irish or whatever. You know, that's a punk rock moment. So I feel with my parents that they came into uncharted waters. That's how I live my life. You know, a lot of Black culture drives trends and drives this kind of raw energy. And it's like, you know, when are you going to give credit where credit's due? So for me, the Black experience is punk experience and, you know, I'm living my truth. Yeah. And my African ancestry as well with the piercings, so don't get it twisted.
I grew up as like a weird kid in school, so I was brought up listening to punk, and I think that's one of the greatest things that I learned. It's not caring what other people think.
But you're just a fool, I could have poisoned you 1,000 times.
There were a lot of sounds, especially that came out of Britain, that definitely influenced me as a kid. It was like polystyrene, X-ray specs, the Slits, Dizzy Rascal, Miss Dynamite, a lot of reggae as well. You can take something from everything. Oh, and I will not be conquered over now by anyone. most unique thing about this country is the culture. It's the melting pot. The tribes that have been formed in Britain definitely have an impact on my generation, because I feel like we don't want to just be one specific tribe, because there's so many great things in each. I'm not going to put boundaries on myself or the music I make. You don't have to conform. When cultures mix together, new rules are created, a new way of life is born.
1,000 times had I been able to live without you.
Into folders, flame for your MIDI and your music controllers.
These black kids can do what they want, like be who you want, like be what you want to be. Like,
I used to be bad when I was a child, I was just a nuisance. Music proper healed me.
This DIY spirit of it all, just such an amazing time for UK music.